hair is weird, isn't it? Some days it looks all right. Some days it's too long. I'm gonna crew cut it. Quiet. After 6 years playing Brenda on General Hospital, our next guest left her daytime fans in critical condition when she moved to primetime's hottest zip code starting November 18th. You could see her on Beverly Hills 90210. Please welcome Vanessa Marcil. Hi, Vanessa.
Hi.
So you're dead. You're dead.
Yes.
On General Hospital, you're dead.
Yes, I'm dead.
But they never found your body, did they?
That's right, just in case I need to pay my mortgage later.
That's right. I enjoy that when they have it, like, lingering. Some
exactly.
people don't like that. I like that.
Yeah, you do?
Yeah, because I don't like people to go away for good, you know? I like them to drive away on the jet ski, have the jet ski blow up, and have no one know.
Exactly.
And then 3 years later...
But it doesn't even matter. Because you can see their body, and they'll come back anyway. And
yeah, that's
say, like,
true.
They were injected with a drug that, you know, keeps the body, whatever.
Right, and I'm at home going, oh, they had the drug.
Yeah.
I'm totally crying and into it. I'm like a loser. But were you upset when they decided to, or did you ask them because you knew you were leaving?
Yeah, I decided to leave. I decided to take a break, and then, you're saying was I upset when they said I was going to die?
Yeah, because, you know, sometimes they could say you're going to visit your aunt in Uganda
I kind of wanted to go visit someone somewhere or whatever.
Yeah.
So I was a little bummed out that they were going to kill her, but, you know, as long as they did the whole not find my body thing, then I was okay with it.
And boy, did they ever kill you in a dramatic way. Your mother decides to drive you...
Yeah, off a cliff.
Off a cliff.
My mother, who I just met, you know, 3 weeks before now.
Yeah.
She's a little dysfunctional.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Was it a tough decision to leave the show? Must have been.
It was a really tough decision.
Yeah, you must miss everyone.
I do. I miss everyone a lot. I watch the show every day in my dressing room on my new show.
And how do you like that 90210? You'd been a fan of it?
I mean, I kind of grew up watching all of them, you know, and they were my idols for a while, and then I got over that. And then now I go there, and they're all such nice people, so they're kind of my idols again.
Now, who are you going to be on that?
My character's name is Gina.
Yeah.
And she's a scandalous, dysfunctional little...
twit.
Little twit. And so she's fun. She's fun to play, because she's a...
And are you related to anyone there? Are you?
I'm Tori Spelling's character, who is Donna's cousin.
You're Donna's cousin?
Mm-hmm.
And you go and steal Donna's man?
Oh, yeah.
Of course, you have to. You're the cousin and everything.
That's right.
You know.
I roll up on her man first episode.
And is that the clip we have?
Yeah, I'm rolling up on Tori Spelling's boyfriend.
In this clip,
take
a look at Vanessa, the cousin you love to hate.
If it's the wrong guy, why'd you fall for him?
Because Donna did first. Sooner or later, he fell for me.
Army of you.
Kind of swarmy,
leave the photos on the chest of the drunk guy.
For Donna to find.
Oh, that's not good.
I know.
Now Luke is coming back on, isn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I saw you guys at the baseball game, did I not?
Yeah, you were
on TV a lot.
Yeah, I'm a huge Yankee fan.
Yeah,
I love Andy Pettit.
He's a cutie,
such a
isn't
babe.
He?
Oh,
you know who's really
gosh.
Cute in real person though? Mark McGuire. He came on the show.
Oh,
in real life.
Can you get me Mark McGuire's autograph?
See what
Did
I can
you
do, Vanessa.
Close friends with him?
Yeah, we're like this. We're buddies. We're going to McDonald's after
oh,
the show.
Oh, God.
Getting a Big Mac. No, but he has
I
the most
Mark
piercing
McGuire.
Green eyes, which you can never really see on TV.
No, I know.
Yeah.
I have this one of those little TVs that I take on the set because I'm a sports fan and I can't miss any of the games. So I was following the whole Mark McGuire thing. And, you know, I'm like sitting there looking at him the whole entire time. I have pictures of him up on my wall.
Really?
Yeah.
He's a very nice man.
Well, we were at the World Series and I couldn't get his autograph.
No.
Yeah, he was like, who are you? You're nobody.
Well, you know, I've read that he... No, that's not what you said. I've read that he only likes to do it when it's for charity, which I think is a good thing in a way. You
exactly.
Know?
Well, I also felt bad because, you know, he wants to sit and watch the game.
Yeah,
he doesn't want
a little
to sign
bit besieged,
autograph.
I think, lately. I hear you have a challenge for me.
I do have a challenge for you.
My staff has set up a spicy food challenge.
Yeah, woo!
Let me tell you a little something, Vanessa. I'm Irish. You know what spicy is for me? Basic Heinz ketchup.
I know you like sweet things, right?
Well, yeah, I don't enjoy the spice. Now, you have crazy spice?
Because I'll come back and do a standoff with the sweet stuff, too.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, bring
I can eat anyone under the table.
Look at you, skinny little nothing. You cannot.
I can
so. Oh, don't challenge me like that.
I'm challenging you, Rosie.
Oh, I will throw down
Where
the
do
Butterfinger. I am throwing down the Butterfinger. All right, bring this out here. right, this is you over here. You're side.
I'm left.
Because
they told
you enjoy the hot stuff. I have Yoo-hoo, Pepsi One, and water to help me.
And what I have nothing.
You have nothing.
<from medicine. laughs>
Because it's your challenge. What do you have for me?
Okay, I have super hot chunky style salsa.
Oh no.
Which is, you know.
Oh no, super hot chunky. All right, pour yours in your bowl. I'll pour mine in the bowl.
Ooh, I like how it's already undone for me, so I don't have to sit and try and open it for 10 minutes.
Exactly. You want to use a Frito? What do you want to use? A Dorito? What are you going for?
You know what we should use? We should use the Flaming Hot Doritos, since all of this stuff is not even much of a challenge. So, you go first.
Can you say ulcer? Spicy hot Dorito.
Spicy hot Dorito.
All right, how much of the salsa can you put on?
Let
me see how much salsa you can put on there.
All right, are you ready?
All right, let me see this, Vanessa. That's a lot, actually. I'm surprised about that.
All right.
Good. Let me see.
Can't believe I'm going to open my mouth this wide right now on television.
You are. Go ahead.
My mother's going to kill me.
Hot? Not even hot for you. All right. Let me take a little. This is a lot. That's
a
lot.
What's that?
Hey, that's a lot for me.
I thought we were having a challenge.
All right. You want more?
Yeah.
All right. How about that? Is that good?
Yeah.
All right. Look.
It's not, right?
Really? It's nothing at all. It's perfectly fine. Can I tell you a little secret?
What?
I put mild in my bowl.
Did you really?
Taste it, it's mild. Take a finger taste. It's totally mild.
That's so scandalous of you.
Yes, but you should feel good in knowing I now have afterburn from the spicy fire hot. Flamin' Hot Dorito. I just choked on that. Flamin' Hot Dorito. Vanessa.
Yes.
That's frightening. All right, we have to do a breast cancer awareness song.
Oh.
We're gonna do it to your favorite musical, which is?
Grease.
Grease. You want to do Grease? All right. Get ready. Wow, my throat hurts. Hey, Vanessa, say it real clear.
Test your breast every year.
Don't be scared. Don't cause no pain.
Unless you have dichotomy.
I love Alan. Listen up. Check your C cup.
Go out, get a mammogram.
Squish ya, squish ya, squish ya, squish. Take a friend, have some fun. Check the left and the right.
You will find when it's done, you can shimmy all night.
No. I can't shimmy, can you?
No, no. I tried though.
Tell everyone when you're on Beverly Hills 90210. Starting.
Oh, my show airs November 18th.
November 18th. Check her out on Beverly Hills. And next, the Backstreet Boys.